the Supreme Court of India has to be perfect. For everyone, from a farmer in Maharashtra to a doctor in Delhi, this is your last stop for justice. This is India's greatest institution. But in the last few months, there has been a historic unraveling. Let's start with one of the biggest reasons for this. How are these judges who make the law of the land selected? Well, they appoint themselves. The Chief Justice of India is the face and figurative head of the Supreme Court. He and four of his senior most colleagues together form a supergroup of sorts called the Collegium. This body recommends judges to the 24 high courts and the Supreme Court of India. But of course, they always don't agree. And this disagreement has left the country with a shortage of about 44% of judges. The government says that this process of selecting judges is neither transparent nor fully objective. And it has time and again tried to regain control. But the Supreme Court has always managed to push back to protect judicial independence. The last such attempt was in 2015, when the Modi government tried to bring in a new legislation. This too came crashing after the Supreme Court declared it unconstitutional. Apart from these, there are other simmering issues. The demand for more judges. At present, India has about 18 judges per million citizens, and we need at least 50 per million. With fewer judges at hand, the courts are unable to handle all the cases that come before it. This means that when you go to court, your case could take years, if not decades. There are currently about 40 lakh cases pending in 24 high courts across the country, and at least 50,000 cases pending in the Supreme Court. To top this, the maximum number of cases are brought by the government of India. As if all of this wasn't enough, Chief Justice of India Deepak Mishra and his senior colleagues started disagreeing on many day-to-day aspects of the court. They questioned how certain sensitive cases were being handled, and they raised complaints that he was preferring junior judges over senior ones. 12 January this year, the entire conflict erupted in public eye. Four judges, Justice Chalameshwar, Ranjan Gogoi, Kurian Joseph and Madan Lokur, held a historic press conference. This press conference was unprecedented because judges do not speak in public. But nothing came of this initially. Chief Justice Deepak Mishra did not respond to allegations or make any effort to address these issues. To make matters worse, allegations of misconduct surfaced against Chief Justice. The opposition saw this as a perfect opportunity to score one against the government. CPIM leader Sitaram Yechury was the first one to talk about impeachment of the Chief Justice of India. Now, this is uncharted territory. No judge in India's history has ever been removed. Rahul Gandhi got the Congress party and six other opposition parties to kickstart the process. 64 signatures of Rajya Sabha members were collected. But how is a judge removed or impeached? According to the Constitution, a minimum number of 50 Rajya Sabha MPs or 100 Lok Sabha MPs can make an application to the Speaker of the House to initiate the proceedings. The Speaker then gets to either accept or reject this motion. On 23rd April 2018, Rajya Sabha Speaker and Vice President Venkaiah Naidu rejected the opposition's motion to impeach Chief Justice Deepak Mishra. If it were to be accepted, a three-member inquiry committee would then have to be set up to look into the allegations against the judge. Based on the inquiry committee report, the judge would then be given a one last chance to defend himself in the parliament. The MPs will then cast their vote to decide if the Chief Justice of India, Deepak Mishra, stays or goes. All of this could still happen. The Congress has decided to challenge Venkaiah Naidu's rejection before the Supreme Court. Public faith in the Supreme Court has been damaged. And in the squabble between judges and politicians, who stands to suffer? Unfortunately, it's you.